Now we are going to enter a short series on purification. What are the impurities? How to manage them? How to clear them? What is the effect of impurities? And what is the effect of purity? How are these impurities an obstacle? And what happens when we remove that obstacle? This will be studied under purification. And before we begin this very practical discussion, there is a warning for you. The measures that are suggested here are based on totally my personal experiences. It is not written anywhere. These are not rules, although they are being practiced since many thousand years and they achieve the desired outcome. But you need to think very carefully before using the means, before employing the tricks given here. Use your wisdom, use your common sense. If something is not broken, do not fix it. And these methods may not work for everybody. You need to do your own assessment because everybody is different. All minds are different. They are very strange. They are very complex. We don't know what can happen there. And finally, you are the one who is responsible for any experiment that you do on yourself. The broad guideline here is do not do it. Always take advice of an expert, of a teacher, of a guru, of somebody who has already done it, who knows what it is. Some of these methods are very mild, like clean yourself, take a bath, and so on. Obviously, for that, you don't need any kind of guidance. But many of them are like precision surgery in the mind, and they should not be done. So we can begin with the definition. Purification is a state of mind that brings ultimate bliss, ultimate liberation, happiness, and freedom. Total and permanent. We clean up the impurities here. And there are possibly infinite kinds of impurities, but the most basic of them is ignorance. Everything else comes out of ignorance of this kind or that kind. And obviously, the cure is knowledge. Knowledge purifies. I told you not to do anything because I know it is already happening. As soon as you know something, the mind starts its own purification. It is very natural. It is very obvious. And nothing else can happen, actually. If you have grasped it, if the knowledge is certain, if you have no doubts about it, everything is going to change. Your actions, your thinking, your speech. There will be minor changes. There will be major changes. The entire being is shifted to a higher state. This happens automatically because of knowledge. You live in a polluted city and one day you read a report that so many people are dying because of pollution. You go and confirm it. You go and see that this is the case. The air is polluted, the water is polluted, the food is polluted. People are polluted. Their minds are polluted. Knowing this, you withdraw yourself from the city. You live in a clean place. And automatically, your health will start improving, your behavior will start improving. This is not a miracle, this is purification. Just by knowing, your actions will change, will bring about the required change, and you will shift towards bliss, freedom, happiness. This is the natural outcome. Nothing more needs to be done. If you are very curious, if you are very intelligent, you know what needs to be done, then go ahead and do it. Do the purification. Now many of you must be laughing that, oh, he finally brought up the purification. You have gone through everything in the universe and finally you remember the purification. And this is not a mistake. On the path of knowledge, we do not do purification. You simply start with the knowledge. I told you why. You start at the layer of the intellect, which governs the rest of the layers. And the layer of the intellect itself governed by awareness, the layer of the awareness. We start at the top and then we observe as the purification trickles down the lower layers. It is very interesting to watch the changes that happen. It is like washing away of all the impurities. And there are paths which are equally valid where the purification is the first. Because how can you even attain knowledge if you are impure? If the body is not working, if your speech is not working, if the intellect is not working, if the emotions are totally out of control, random, how will you learn anything? So, they start with purification. And as soon as the student is ready for something, that knowledge is then imparted. It is a long process. And I call it the bottom-up process. Because we start at the bottommost layer, which is usually your body or even below that, like the surroundings of the body, environment. When the teacher sees that enough purification has been achieved, the teaching is given. It is very effective. It is like forging the iron when it is red hot. It works. But you know, the path of knowledge is a direct path. We don't do all these things. We simply hit the mind with knowledge. If it is plastic, if it is malleable, it changes. If not, the student is told to take another path. So in the top-down process, we start with the intellect and awareness. Here, I'm going to start with the bottom. And there is a reason for that, that most of us do not understand anything else. We drop down to the bottom, just like other traditions. Why? You have seen the top already. In the last 50-60 episodes, we are at the top. We have done nothing about the bottom. So when it comes to purification, my advice is to start from the bottom. Because the top down is already happening. If you want to assist in the purification process, start from the bottom. So that now, both the processes are happening. This is a smart decision. The top down is already happening because of your knowledge and wisdom. Now you give it a helping hand from bottom up. Now you get the best of both worlds. Actually, this is the complete purification. Nothing else remains to be done. Nothing will be missing now. And you will feel that I am doing something for my spiritual life, which is the complaint of many people on the path of knowledge, that you never told me to do anything. I feel as if I am doing nothing to progress. And for such people, we prescribe these practices of purification. Okay, do this. If this is what makes you happy, if this is what makes you feel like spiritual, yes, keep doing it. There is no limit to it, but there is a rational limit, which means do not do too much of it. It's not worth it. Remember, you are already purest. You are already whole and complete. You're already liberated and blissful. So there is no point in doing anything. If you're already established in the bliss, if you've already achieved the liberation, and happiness and freedom are peanuts for you, then don't waste your time. Do something which you like. The purification will happen. And if it does not, you're always free to fix things here and there. It is not that I told you don't do anything, so you don't do anything. As I said, use your wisdom and common sense. If it is forced on you, it's not good. But if you feel like improving someplace, yes, sure. There is a huge impact of purification, especially if you speed it up, especially if you do it consciously. So be ready for a tremendous amount of shifts in your life. It is not simply a feel-good thing. It is going to change everything. Changes the body, the speech, thought, behavior, and so your relationships will be changed. Whatever you feel and emotions, everything will be changed. You'll get different kind of desires. No more lowly desires. Your intellect is going to change. And finally, the purification will bring intense awareness. It is a self-feeding loop. The more purification you do, the more it happens, the more your intellect and awareness will be effective. It is like oiling the machinery and it starts running faster. And so more purification happens. The impurities are thrown away completely. That's why I said it's very interesting. If you want to enter this field of purification,